This was entertainment back in the Depression days, a time when just standing and grinning into a movie camera was a great joy.
Now this film is King's Mountain, made in the year 1937.
H. Lee Waters was ahead of his time. He traveled the dirt roads of the Carolinas back in the 30s, putting people in the movies.
I hit this thing just right before we had television, you see. These are candid pictures, just people walking along and weren't expecting to see a movie camera.
Mr. Waters went to more than 100 towns with this old 16-millimeter movie camera. His visits were advertised in advance, and the town was usually waiting. They brought their kids to show off, or their tubas. Of course, there was no sound, but it was a priceless opportunity, a chance to get on the silver screen, just like Shirley Temple or Will Rogers.
You were kind of a hero in those towns, weren't you?
In a way, especially kids. I love kids in a way. I had a few little tricks I'd show them, you know, and do my feet like that, you know.
To modern youngsters who've been nourished on the likes of Star Wars, such entertainment may seem foolish, but in 1930, it was magical. And H. Lee Waters misses the innocence of those days.
Do you wish we could be entertained this simply today?
Yes, I do. And that is Depression years, too.
I mean, there's
people were happy. And they didn't have enough to eat, but still they were happy.
H. Lee Waters was happy, too. And he was creative. He probably made some of America's first commercials. For 15 or 20 bucks, he would include local businesses in some of his films, such as these in King's Mountain.
You were kind of ahead of your time doing commercials, weren't you?
Yes, but I saw the possibility of it, and the commercials would vary in price depending on what they wanted done. But that is the main revenue that I get from the films.
Main Street here in Lexington has changed a lot since 1926. But H. Lee Waters' studio hasn't changed a bit. He's still in the same storefront, and he's still using the same camera he started with 60 years ago.
What you do with the camera, no matter what model it is, old model or new model, you got to have some of it up here, you know.
Mr. Waters still has a lot up there. Nothing's faded in his 83 years, nothing except some of his old pictures. So these days, he makes his living mostly by restoring old photos.
It has a spray of paint, dye, about the size of a point of a needle.
And some of those old pictures draw curious young people to his studio. Youngsters who just can't believe there was happiness before television.
Looks like he might be a Western Union boy there.
H. Lee Waters says we could never get away with entertainment this simple in the 80s. And he thinks that's too bad. Too bad because these scenes from the 30s tell us something.
It tells us this, that whatever you have, try to be satisfied with it and make the best of it. And you had a good idea? That's what I've read in the good book and other places, too. If you're too hard to satisfy, why, you have a hard time.